and blue. There's nothing more a man could do. Don't get your bollocks in a twist. Settle down, don't take a fit. You drank a demon straight from hell.
Mike Figgis invited me to a screening of a hotel which we filmed at the Directors Guild, and I went, and this lady pounced on me at the end of the screening and introduced herself, and it was Tammy, you know, and she was great, very lovely and bubbly, and she said, "I've got this script, you've got to do it," and you know, blah blah blah. Cut a long story short, she ran me to do a reading, and I just asked who else was reading, what were the other cast members, and at the time it was good actually, because there's three other actors that did the reading are in the movie, but Malcolm McDowell, who plays my father, obviously was there at the reading, and I'd always had a weird thing about Malcolm where Clockwork Orange is one of my favourites, and a lot of people used to say I have a resemblance of him a little bit when he was younger, you know. I personally think I'm a lot more attractive, but he won't mind that. No, but I really did have a vibe about Malcolm, you know, and the Northern thing and so on and so forth. So I said, "Look, I'll come to the reading," but I was filming at the time and I was working heavy days, and I said, "I'll come to the reading, but only if Malcolm's definitely going to be going," because I'd not met Tammy. I didn't know what the vibe was, whether she was calling these names and no one would turn up and I'd just be there with Larry OneNote reading the part of my dad, you know. So they rang and they said, "Yeah, he's going to..." Got there, met Malcolm, lovely, charming, beautiful vibe. And the other actors were great. 1, 2, 3, 4 actors, Greg, Heather, Olivia, were great.
I didn't fly the plane, but thank you, Mr. Torsey. We were lucky to get in with the fog and turbulence.
I was hoping to get in myself tonight.
To the bar for a couple of pints. You wouldn't want to join me, would you?
For a drink?
Aye.
With you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, why not?
Grand.
You from Dublin?
Ah, once upon a time.
The thing that attracted me to Johnny is, and to most characters that I do really, is they are multifaceted, you know. And if on page they're not, you really do, as an actor, I think it's your job to find nuances with them, to make them not one-dimensional, you know, and to give them flip sides that sometimes are overt and sometimes are complete secrets. And with him, with Johnny, there's so much going on, you know. There's a lot of male testosterone, male stuff going on, which is represented by a lot of men in the world, I think, where you have this big gregarious guy and da-da-da-da-da, but deep down there's loads of other layers to him. He's incredibly angry, incredibly boisterous, cavalier, but at the same time really fundamentally like bang on with everything in his life. It's as if he takes his psyche out and goes do-do-do-do-do-do-do, but he gives the impression that he's a cavalier young guy and he's a, you know, rock and roller. But he has that anger about his father and about his sisters, but he also has an incredible amount of love for them all. And I think out of the whole family, the death affects him more than anyone. The fact that he can't have a cuddle off his dad anymore really, really affects him terribly, you know. And it's what happens in real life, I feel, that, you know, if you're pushed into a corner through a certain emotion that you're not comfortable with, you come out with the exact opposite, you know, and that's him. He steams into this film, bang. How are you doing, how are you? Nice to see you, sis. You can get that, bang, you can get that, and off we go with the beers. When in actual fact, he's going, "Oh, all I want is a cuddle."
You pluck your eyebrows, Tom.
Sorry.
Tweezers, you know, do you pluck your eyebrows?
No, I don't. I'm a man.
Well, nobody's perfect, Tom. Should see some of the creatures, me sister.
What I like about Tammy, basically, is, and what I think is important about directors, and the best type of directors I've worked with, they give you an input of what they like and what they want and how they see the thing, but they also give you space to go and work and create. Because I feel that I've not directed anything, but I've put myself into that mindset, and a director has once said to me that we overlook everything, but you specifically look and create and live and breathe one that dynamic of that whole dimension. That's like you are really breathing that all day. And if there's six people doing that, there are going to be things that get out that you as a director might not have clocked and gone, oh, maybe that's an angle. So what he said to me, this guy, was that he likes to see what everyone brings to the table, because sometimes there can be bits of magic that you just by your workload might not have got, you know. And Tammy lets us come on the set, work through things, and she watches and she either digs things or she doesn't, and she just goes, bang, keep that, lose that, let's go. And that's it for me.